Hi friend, welcome all to my educational channel Math A to Z. This is the second class of MCQ Real Analysis. We discuss here some important MCQ type question with answer. Together with its explanation, basically on differential calculus. Now, the first question is, here the function fx equal to mod of x plus 1 minus mod x. And we know that mod x, if the function is mod x, then it is not differentiable at x equal to 0. So, if the function is mod of x plus 1, then it is not differentiable at x plus 1 equal to 0, that is x equal to minus 1. So, clearly, we say that about this function, the function is not differentiable at x equal to 0 and x equal to minus 1. So, the option 4. The function is differentiable except at 0 and minus 1. And all the other points, the function is differentiable. So, the option 4 is correct. This is very easy question. Second question. Here, it is given that f plus g and f minus g, both are differentiable. Now, we can write f is equal to half into a plus g plus f minus g. So, since this and this are given that both differentiable, so the sum of two differentiable function is also differentiable, that is f is also differentiable. Similarly, g can be written as half into a plus g minus f minus g. And this is the difference of or subtraction of two differentiable function. So, obviously, this is also differentiable. So, our option is the first, f and g both are differentiable. First option is correct. Here, the function fx is given by a0 cos mod x plus a1 sin mod x plus a2 mod x square. Since this function is differentiable at x equal to 0, so we must have left hand derivative and right hand derivative are equal. Now we calculate the left hand derivative as limit x tends to 0 minus fx minus f0 by x minus 0. And this gives limit x tends to 0 minus, this is a0 cos x, this is minus a1 sin x, this is a2 x cube, minus f of 0, this is a0 by x minus 0. So, limit x tends to 0 minus a0 into cos x minus 1 minus a1 sin x minus a2 x cube by x. And this is the limit of the form 0 by 0. Right. So, we differentiate numerator and denominator. And using L-Hospital rule, we get limit x tends to 0 minus a0 into sin x, this is minus sin x, and this is minus 0 minus a1 cos x minus 3 a2 x square by 1. Obviously, taking limit x tends to 0, we get this is minus a1. And similarly, if we take right hand limit, then we get here, this is obviously plus, this is also plus, this is also plus. So this plus and this plus. And this is plus, this is plus. So here we take plus, otherwise, sorry, this is also plus, otherwise all the same. So this limit is given by a1. Now here minus a1, this is equal to a1. So 2a1 equal to 0, that is a1 equal to 0. And this is the option 3. This is the correct option. Here, f dash x less equal to g dash x for all x less than a, and f dash x greater equal to g dash x for all x greater than a. And it is also given that f and g are both differentiable functions. So if we take phi equal to f minus g, then phi is also differentiable. And phi dash x is obviously less equal to 0 for all x less than a, and phi dash x greater equal to 0 for all x greater than a. That is, this is increasing, monotonic increasing, and this is monotonic decreasing for x greater than a and this x less than a. Now we go to the first option. If this is x equal to a, and here it is given that f of a greater equal to g of a, that is phi of a greater equal to 0. So the curve lies upper side of x axis. Let here is phi of a. Now if we draw the picture according to these two conditions, this side is curve negative and this side is curve positive, or this is may not be a straight line, this is also okay. So all for all x belongs to R, we say that the curve on the upper side of x axis. So we go through the first option. The option 1 is correct. But if we take the second option, here it is given that phi of a less equal to 0. Okay. So the function is here, phi of a is the lower side of x axis. Now left side, in the left side, the phi is negative, sorry, phi is monotonic decreasing here. And on the right side, the phi is monotonic increasing. So the function may be of the form this is monotonic decreasing, and this is monotonic increasing. So here phi of x greater than 0, here phi of x greater than 0, but from here to here phi of x less than 0. So we cannot say about phi of x for all x. Okay, so we cannot write fx less than or less equal to g of x for all x. So the option 1 is correct. This is very easy question, and here fx is sin x, gx is cos x, and Cauchy's mean value theorem f dash c by g dash c is equal to fb minus fa by gb minus ga. Now we put the value, we get here cos c by minus sin c, this is equal to sin b minus sin a by cos b minus cos a. And we directly calculate this, we get cot c is equal to cot of a plus b by 2, that is c equal to a plus b by 2, that is c is the am of a and b, So the option 1 is correct. Here fx is equal to root x minus x. Clearly this function is continuous on 0, 1. This function is differentiable on 0, 1 because 0 exclude here, so this function is also differentiable. And last condition, f of 0 is equal to f of 1 is equal to 0. So Rolle's theorem must be applicable. Now to find the value of c, we differentiate this f dash x equal to 1 by 2 root x minus 1, and f dash c, this is equal to 1 by 2 root c minus 1 equal to 0, that is c equal to 1/4. This belongs to 0, 1. So the Rolle's theorem is applicable and we get the value of c, this is equal to 1/4, belongs to 0, 1, and for that value f dash c equal to 0. So the option 1 is correct. Last question of the class. Here fx equal to max of sin x cos x for all x belongs to R, and all the option is on differentiability. Okay, when sin x greater than cos x, then we get this value as sin x, and we know that sin x is differentiable everywhere. So at that time the function is differentiable. Also if cos x greater than sin x, then this value is also cos x, and this is also a differentiable function. But when sin x and cos x are both equal, then we cannot find the maximum of sin x cos x. At that point this function is not differentiable. So the function is not differentiable at the point where tan x equal to 1. So at the point x equal to n pi plus pi by 4, n belongs to capital N. Okay, so the point where the function is not differentiable is x such that x equal to n pi plus pi by 4, n belongs to capital N. And here the option 4 is given that f is differentiable except at the countable set of point, and this is obviously countable set of point because for n, f of n, this is equal to n pi plus pi by 4. So this is countable set of point, and except this point the function is differentiable. So the option 4 is correct. Okay, so this is the today's class. Thank you for watching.